didn't like a good bench. What's that, sir?
Nope.
Have you been here before?
No, sir.
Mind if I tell you a little bit about it, then you can be on your way?
Sure.
Oh, sure. You like?
Mine is where most people want to sit. That's where the prison is struck at night.
Huh?
They have guided tours every 15, 20 minutes, all right? So I'll tell you, what you're in right now is the ruins of the first state prison for the state of Connecticut.
Mm-hmm.
1773, there's nothing here. Prisons were kept out above ground, we believe, right up there, around, enclosed with a fence, with armed guards around there. There were no spotlights, no nothing, so,
uh-huh.
You know, you couldn't, you got to remember, it's 1773, right? So, what happened is, the state of the Connecticut decided, well, they had to do something, because they had to be able to keep track of the prisoners at night, okay?
Yeah.
What did they do? They had a copper mine and a prison, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Where was the copper mine? Right here.
Mm-hmm.
Where was the copper mine? Straight down. So what they did, they used the ladder. There were two entrances to the copper mine. Ladders went straight down 40, 50 feet.
Wow.
So what they did with the prisoners every night for a long period of time, until such time as they had enough bungalows or whatever you want to call them, bunks, places where to sweep above ground.
Mm-hmm.
Every night the prisoners would force to go down that ladder and sweep on hard rock down there. Okay.
Ooh.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
When you go into the tunnel, think about what it was like to be a prisoner, knowing that you were going to be there for 5 years, 10 years, whatever it is.
Yeah.
And you were going to go sweep at night down, had to climb down this ladder, all right? And you got down there, you slept on hard rock, and the only good thing about it is you're down there with 50 or 60 of your best buddies, you know? Other crooks.
At least you got that.
Other crooks.
other crooks,
all right? So it was that way until that such time as they built enough places to sweep up above ground.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Where we're standing right now, when prisoners came in, they were supposed to learn a craft. They were going to be taught to do something, and they learned a craft. We're standing right now in that pamphlet you have there. If you look there, you're in the nail shop. This is the nail shop right here. They learned how to make nails. And it was a two-story building. You filled up because you had windows up on top.
Oh, yeah.
And you could see where the roof, where the ceiling and the floor was, the ceiling for the down part, and it was right across there. So building that you see here, the guardhouse, that was built in 1779, and it's the only building that was built and was up when there were prisons around, and still stands today. And exactly what it was like back then, what it is like now. All the other buildings that were built, and you could see where there were a lot of buildings within the walls. The walls went up in 1802. The other buildings suffered the problems of time, fire,
right.
You know, roof damage, you know, it just made it through, except for this one building. The government failed to, or did not appreciate the feedback they were getting about the prisoners and the care they were getting. Inhumane, they said, for prisoners and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
So they what the hell, is it raining already?
Yep.
So,
especially kind of nice.
And they were checking how expensive it was, too.
Had a bit of technical difficulty. All good. Yeah.
Wow.
That's a creepy give me a roll. This guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't look happy at all. Take a selfie in front of a creepy ass mural.
Now, I meant to ask you earlier if you had a selfie stick.
I don't have my selfie stick. Oh, Liberty.
The doorbell rang. See this go like all the way down, but it doesn't. It's right there.
Oh.
I wish you could see it on camera. But we haven't got around to get night vision yet.
Let's see. I see daylight.
So cool if I get some EVPs in here.
Huh?
It's so cool if I can get EVPs in here.
I think you might in the tunnel. Talk about like a tease. You look, there's like all these mountains and scenery in the background, and you just be in this fucking.
Locked up in here?
Yeah. But I wanna go!
I wonder if I can fit through these bars.
Thank you. I was just thinking, like there's a space in the wall. So, like, if this is how it was originally, like, if your friend was in the next cell, you'd just be like, give me food. Something. Like, let's shake hands. They could thumb wrestle. That'll kill time.
Touch me.
Touch this.
That'd be a pleasure.
Oh. Ooh, shit. Quiet up there.
Can I go to Smelters?
Hey.
I'm trying to do a little video zipping first and then take a few more pics. Ugh.
So we haven't narrated too much. I mean, it's actually pretty cool. It's about $8 for adults to get in. You can walk the grounds, which isn't, you know, a ton, but it's a little bit. And you can walk the grounds by yourself, and you can tour the copper mine, which is really cool, but not if you're claustrophobic or you have trouble, like, with low, really low ceilings.